not just regular permutations, super permutations can leap tall buildings in a single bound permutations. What is a super permutation? First of all, let's talk about an ordinary permutation. A permutation is just like a shuffle. So imagine I had three cards, one, two, and three. How many ways can I shuffle those three cards? So let's do that. These are the permutations, one, two, three. And we could have one, three, two, two, one, three, two, three, one. And we could have three, one, two, and three, two, one. There are six permutations that use the numbers one to three, and that is three factorial. Just to remind people, three factorial means three times two times one. And that's because we've got three choices for the first one, two choices for the second one, and one choice for the last one, and you multiply those choices together, that's three factorial, that's six. There are six ways to do it. Now, a super permutation, it's a string of numbers that contains all the permutations. So the super permutation of one, two, and three would have all the permutations of one, two, and three contained within it. So we could just string these together. Oh, that's, yeah, simple, right. One, two, three, one, three, two, two, one, three, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. So that's a super permutation. It has length 18. You don't seem that impressed with that super permutation. It doesn't deserve its name as being super. Okay, we can do better. What is the smallest string of numbers that we can write that contains all the permutations? Well, how about this one? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. All right, this has length 9, but it is a super permutation, and it's the shortest super permutation using 1, 2, 3. Let's check that
so
it has.
So you've used overlaps, basically.
I have used overlaps. Let's check. 1, 2, 3, that's in there. 1, 3, 2, I've got it here. 2, 1, 3, where is it? There it is. 2, 3, 1, right there near the beginning. 3, 1, 2, I bet that is here. And 3, 2, 1 is right at the end. Yes, it contains all the permutations, but it is the shortest string that contains all the permutations, and it has length 9. So let's have a look at the shortest super permutations for all the values. 1 to 3, 1 to 4. Let's have a look. So let's start with 1. Okay. The super permutation containing all the permutations of 1 is 1. And then we just check. Yes, that contains all the permutations. It has length what? Great. What is the super permutation for 1 and 2? It is 1, 2, 1. So it has 1 and 2, and it has 2 and 1. That's all you need, and that has length 3, as you can see. Now, for 3, we've done that one, and we have a super permutation of length 9. Now, 4. I'm going to tell you, 4 has length 33. So let's have a look at what that looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 1. There we go. So that has length 33, and it contains all the permutations. So 5, what is the super permutation 5? It has length 153. Shall I write that one out?
No, it's escalating.
It is escalating. And then for 6, don't know.
No.
We don't know what is the super permutation or the minimum super permutation using 1 to 6. We have a guess. Okay, so there is a pattern and maybe this guess is right. Have a look. This first number, it was 1. That is 1 factorial. The second number is 3. Actually, that turns out to be 1 factorial plus 2 factorial. 9, 1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus 3 factorial. You might notice a pattern. 4, 33. Well, that is 1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 4 factorial. What do you guess 5 is going to be?
1 to 5
yeah.
Factorials.
1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 4 factorial plus 5 factorial is 153. So 6, what do you guess 6 is going to be? Adding up the factorials. Let's do it. 1 factorial plus 2 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 4 factorial plus 5 factorial plus 6 factorial. 873. I think that's a pretty good guess for the minimum length of the super permutation using 1 to 6. Unfortunately, recently someone found a super permutation That is shorter. In fact, they found a super permutation that had length 872. One shorter. The pattern did not hold. It was one shorter. So, and I can show you what that looks like. This is it on the screen.
No way.
And we still don't know if that's the shortest one. We still don't know if the answer is 872. It's possible there is a shorter one out there. It was a little bit of a shock. Well, you can see this pattern, and there's a reason why you would think this pattern would hold. There is a way to construct the next super permutation from the previous one. And if you construct it in that way, then absolutely the super permutation will have that length. And so they were just thinking, well, that must be the minimum length. This shows they were wrong. It isn't the minimum length. It is not necessary for it to be the minimum length. Now you can see that this might become harder the larger these numbers become. So it's actually computationally hard. So maybe we'll find what the minimum length is for 6, but then we'll have to work out 7 and so on. And this is going to get harder and harder unless we find some clever construction of the minimum superpermutations that tells us what the minimum length is. This is worth comparing to something called de Brown sequences. And de Brown sequences are a similar idea, but they contain all the sequences using, let's say, 1 to 3. It would contain all the sequences. It would look like this. So here's a de Brown sequence. Similar idea. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 3, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 1, 1. So here we have a sequence and it contains all sequences of length 3 using numbers 1 to 3. So 1, 1, 1 is in there. 1, 1, 2 is in there. 333 is in there, 313 is in there. So de Brown sequences are a lot like super permutations, but the sequences inside are allowed to contain duplicates. But we have a way to construct de Brown sequences, and it constructs the minimum length de Brown sequence as well. And they have practical applications in robotics and in actually lots of other areas as well, DNA sequencing and lots of unexpected applications. So de Brown sequences, although I think should be harder really, but they're completely understood, but super permutations, they're still a little bit mysterious.
The Great Courses Plus is an on-demand video service with lessons and courses taught by leading professors from universities and institutions all around the world. They've got an extensive library of 8,000 videos covering pretty much anything that might take your fancy, from playing chess to the geography of Antarctica. I'm actually heading to Antarctica myself in the next few weeks, so I've been paying particularly close attention to those lessons.
It's about 50% larger than the United States, including Alaska.
They're really good, really in-depth stuff.
If all of this ice melted, the global sea level would rise about 60 meters. That's 200 feet.
But whatever you're into, you're going to find something really good here. Learn at your own pace. No homework, no teachers telling you off, but new stuff being added to the site every month. For a free trial on The Great Courses Plus, and to show some support for Numberphile, go visit thegreatcoursesplus.com/numberphile. That's the address there, thegreatcoursesplus.com/numberphile. Our thanks to them for supporting this episode.